Hi students, myself Payal Christie and you can subscribe my channel on YouTube for more videos. And today we are going to study the third part of figure of speech. And the first figure of speech today we are going to study is climax. Climax is a series of ideas in an ascending order. That is from lower to higher, means the words that are of least importance and it goes towards the higher ones. From the examples it will be clear. Life, liberty and the pursuit of happiness. Now here pursuit means search. So the lowest word here is life. First comes life, then comes liberty. Liberty means freedom and the pursuit of happiness, and after getting the freedom a person search for the happiness. So here students, you have to remember, whenever the climax figure of speech is given, then it will start into ascending order, that is from lower to higher. Second example, he came, he fought, he conquered. Now first of all he came, and after that what he did? He fought, and after fighting he conquered. Conquered means won or victory. Third example, I came, I ran, I won. So first here I came, he came. Afterwards what he did? He ran, and afterwards he won. So came, after came, ran, that is of little bit of higher importance, and afterwards won is the, we can say it is higher than compared to ran. So whenever the words according to their importance are given into ascending order, then you have to write the figure of speech climax. And from the sentence itself also you will come to know that, see, comma will be mentioned there. After life there is comma. In the second example also, after came there is comma, fought comma. In the third example also, came comma, ran comma, and after one there is a full stop. But you have to see one thing, is that the words that will move from lower to higher level. The second figure of speech is anticlimax. Now anticlimax is very easy if you are clear with climax. Anticlimax is opposite of climax. Now here the series of ideas are in a descending order. That is from higher to lower. In climax we have seen the words, their importance is from lower to higher, but in anticlimax, higher to lower, that is totally opposite of climax. Let's see the example. He lost his family. So first of all, a very important thing for him is his family, then his car and his purse. So according to the importance, first family comes, then his car and then his purse. So higher importance, okay, the words which have the higher importance come first, and then it goes according to the descending order. As we have seen in math, okay, ascending and descending. In the same way you have to remember in climax and anticlimax. I saw nervous parents, their children and their pets. So first of all, the important persons over here are parents, and after parents comes the children and their pets. The kingdom consists of king, queen and soldiers. So in the kingdom we know that the person at the higher position is known as king. So here the king comes first, and then comes queen, and then comes soldier. Okay, soldiers. So in anticlimax you have to remember that the series of ideas will be in descending order. The third figure of speech is pun. It is a humorous, play on words with multiple meanings. Now here, the word which is given will have more than two or more meanings, and humorous means in a form of joke or comic manner we can say. So here the words which are given will have either two or more meanings. That's why it is said multiple meanings. Let's see the example. Fishes are smart because they live in school. Now see, here the word school is given. Fishes will not go to school. But the word school here for fishes is mentioned a collective noun for fishes. Means a group of fishes is known as school. All the fishes together, and the collective noun is school. And the second meaning of the school is a place to study, means where you go to study, that is known as school. So here the word school has two meanings. That is, a group of fishes is known as school, and the second meaning of the school is a place to study, where the children go to study. I completed all my homework. Now homework means the homework which a teacher gives, that is a school homework. And the second meaning is the household work, means the housework which we do, that is known as homework. So here also the homework has two meanings. You are a man of weight. Now here weight is a measurement, we can say in kilogram, and weight means power. A person who possesses a lot of power, who has a power, is known as weight. And the another meaning of weight is kilogram. So here the word which has two meanings or more than two meanings, then that figure of speech is known as pun. The fourth figure of speech is euphemism. A way of speaking unpleasant things in a pleasant manner. Now see students, you have to remember one thing, that a way of speaking harsh words, okay, unpleasant words, in a very mild way, in a pleasant way. Now let's see the example. He could not make it in exams. So the meaning of this sentence is he failed in exams. But if we tell to someone that you failed in exams, so that will be very harsh words, okay? Unpleasant words for that person. But instead of that, it is said that he could not make it in exams. And that is given in a very pleasant way. This sentence is mentioned here in a pleasant way. His father passed away. Passed away means died. Now if we say that his father died, so that would be very unpleasant word. Died would be very unpleasant word. But instead of that, if we use passed away, so it would be a pleasant word. And this sentence would be mentioned in a pleasant manner. So whenever this type of sentences are given, okay, which are spoken, the unpleasant things are spoken in a pleasant manner, then that figure of speech is known as euphemism. Don't tell a fairy tale. If somebody is telling lies, then we tell that don't tell a fairy tale. Fairy tale means to tell a lie. If we use the word lie, then that would be very harsh or unpleasant. But instead of that, if we say don't tell a fairy tale, then that would be a pleasant sentence. So whenever the unpleasant things that are presented in a pleasant manner, the figure of speech is euphemism. Paradox. Two ideas or statement which are contradictory, that is opposite. Now students, don't get confused here with oxymoron and paradox. In oxymoron, two opposite words are given, whereas in paradox, two ideas or statement which are contradictory, that is opposite to each other. Let's understand by the example. Don't go to the water until you have learned how to swim. Now if you want to swim, you have to go to water, towards water, okay? You have to go in water if you want to learn to swim. But now see, here the ideas both are opposite. Okay, the statement which is given, the first and the second one, that is opposite to each other, that is contradictory to each other. That if we want to swim, we have to go in the water. Water, water everywhere, not any drop to drink. Now there is water everywhere, plenty of water is there, but not any drop to drink, means there is not even a single drop to drink. So here also two ideas or statement which are opposite to each other. Death is the end, yet the beginning. Now we know that a person dies, so that is the end of his or her life, but here in the second statement it is mentioned yet the beginning. So whenever two ideas or statement which are contradictory, that is opposite to each other, then this figure of speech is paradox. Don't get confused with oxymoron. In oxymoron, two opposite words are given, whereas in paradox, two ideas or statements which are opposite, they are mentioned. And the sixth figure of speech is sine die. Okay, the sixth figure of speech is sine die. A part that represents the whole, means a part is only used to represent a whole thing. And please remember the pronunciation, that is sine die. Okay, examples: his face was tired. Now here instead of his body, his face is only mentioned here. So here it represents a part, that is whole. He has many mouths to feed. Now he has many mouths, means plenty of people are there whom he has to give to. He has to give food, but he has mentioned only the mouth, that is a part of the body. He has many mouths to fill. So whenever a part is used, okay, that represents the whole thing, that is known as sine die. Your son is in good hands in the hospital. Now here the son, he is not taken care only by two hands, but he is taken care by the doctors, nurses, assistants, whoever is there in the hospital. But here the only a part is mentioned, that is hands are mentioned. Okay, so whenever a part that represents the whole, that is the face, mouths, hands, if this kind of words are given, then the figure of speech is sine die. And another thing also we can say, that the wheels of the car. So the wheels mention the car. So a part that represents the whole, that is known as sine die. Thanks for watching the video. Have a nice day.